You see my fire? You see my fire? You gotta be a big deal to have fire, people. It means I'm a big goddamn deal. Let me tell you why I got fire. Let me tell you why. I went to go see Jay-Z and Kanye perform, right? These niggas had a bunch of fire. I was like, yo, this show is the shit, because they got fire. No comedian has ever had fire. I'm about to be the first comedian with some fucking fire. So, because of that, throughout my show, you're gonna see a bunch of pointless fire. You're laughing, I'm not playing, I'm dead serious. You think it's a game? Get fire on these bitches one time. It's about to be a bunch of fucking fire. This show's gonna be hot, literally. A lot of shit to talk about, man. I wanna talk about the fact that I'm happy. I'm happy right now, people. I wanna explain why I'm happy. First of all, my divorce is final. That's the first reason why. Now, here's what I wanna explain about my divorce. Everybody assumes that because you went through a divorce, you went through a fucked up period of life. You hate each other. You're enemies. It's not true. At the end of the day, that's the mother of my kids. I'm always gonna respect her as the mother of my kids. She's happy. She's moved on. I'm happy. I moved on. I'm happier than she is, though. I am. No, I am. I'm doing a lot of happy shit right now, people. You have no idea. I took a fucking walk the other day. Do you know how happy you gotta be to take a goddamn walk? To just go outside and start fucking walking? I knew I was happy because I was talking to myself while I was walking. I was like, you hungry? I could eat. It was just me, though. Like, nobody else was there. I stopped. I fed pigeons. That's some happy shit. You gotta be happy to feed pigeons. Here's the beautiful thing about me feeding pigeons. When I was done feeding the pigeons, I didn't have to lie about it. See, when you marry, you lie about shit like that. You're doing something as dumb as feeding some goddamn pigeons. There's not a married man in this audience right now that can go out and feed pigeons. And his wife call, and she say, babe, where you at? And you go, I'm feeding pigeons. And she believed that she was feeding some fucking pigeons. It'll never happen. It's an argument off the bat. Where you at, babe? I'm out here feeding pigeons. You ain't feeding no damn pigeons. What you talking about? I am feeding the pigeons. Then put the pigeon on the fucking phone. What? Let me talk to the goddamn pigeon. There ain't no pigeon. Tell a bitch sitting next to you that's making pigeon noise in the phone, when I see her, I'ma beat her ass. Oh, fake pigeon noise making ass, bitch. Oh, not knowing how to sound like a pigeon ass, bitch. Matter of fact, tell that bitch when I see her, I'ma grab a real pigeon and smack the shit out of her with it. She can see what a real pigeon sound like. Oh, false pigeon, vocal cord having ass, bitch. Hey, I'm fucking killing y'all, man. Get fire on these bitches one time. I'm at a point now where I understand who I am as a man. I know my pros, I know my cons. Here's what's bad about me, people. I'm a liar. I love to lie. I don't know why. I wish I could stop. I can't. I think I'm sick. It's a disease. I don't even tell good lies. I tell a bunch of dumbass lies on a regular basis. Let me tell you something. There's nothing worse than telling a dumbass lie and getting caught telling a dumbass lie. For example, I don't like to talk on my cell phone. I can't stand talking on my phone. But I don't know how to tell people that I don't like to talk on my phone. I think that makes like an asshole. So I would much rather lie about it. Here's how I got caught the other day. I'm in my car. I'm driving. My boy calls me while I'm driving. I pick up. Yo, what up? Kev, what's going on? Instantly, I lied. I said, dude, I can't be on the phone like that. I'm out the country. I'm not trying to have a high-ass phone bill. This is no bullshit. This is what I heard. He said, nigga, ain't that you at the stoplight right there in front of me? I said, what? I'm so oblivious to lying, I waved. What's up, man? What's going on with you, baby? Why you say you was out the country? I didn't say that. I never said that. I don't want to be a liar. I don't. I blame y'all. It's y'all fault. Because y'all put me in positions where I have no choice but to lie. For example, I'm here. I'm in New York. I'm at the airport. I'm in... off. She loses her fucking mind. As soon as she saw me, she was like, oh, my God, no, Kevin. Oh, no. I can't believe this. God must be playing a trick on me. Oh my God, I said I was gonna see you and then I see you and now I'm looking at you. Oh my God, I can't believe it. Oh my God. Can you do me a favor? Can you wait here for like 30 minutes? My mom is about to land. She would love to get a picture with you. I was like, fuck yeah, I'll wait. Go ahead, go get her. As soon as she left, I took off. Bitch, I'm not standing here for no 30 minutes waiting for your goddamn mom. No, kill yourself. Die today. Death to you, bitch, die. I'm not fucking waiting for you. But I can't say that. If I say that, that makes me like an asshole. There's certain lies that I can't tell. For example, I can't tell big lies. The reason why I can't tell big lies is because I'm one of those people that start to believe the lie. Like, once I get that ball rolling, I can't stop. You know who I respect? I respect people that work a 9-to-5 job that can show up late for work without an excuse. They show up, take full responsibility. Hey, I'm sorry I'm late. It'll never happen again. I overslept. I apologize. It's irresponsible on my behalf to do that. Because I can't do that because I'm a fucking liar. I am. If I'm late, something happened. I don't give a shit. Something drastic happened. Yo, dude, sorry I'm late. I was on the highway and a fucking baby was running on the highway. Yeah, I know, right? Shit's crazy. So I get out the car, I start chasing the baby. In my mind, I'm like, why are you running, baby? That's what I'm thinking, right? But I'm like, what do you do? Because I can't just grab the baby and throw the baby in the car. That's kidnapping. I fuck around, go to jail. I got a little butt. I'll get raped. I know they'll fucking rape me in jail. I ain't trying to get raped. So I had to make a decision. I was like, shit, what do I do? So I decided to adopt the baby. What I did was I downloaded this app on my iPhone, this Adopt the Baby app, right? I put the barcode on the baby head. Boop. That way the baby knew he was my baby. I put the baby in the car, I go to pull off, I turn around, a deer was running towards the car. So I'm like, oh shit, this deer is about to eat the baby. That's what I'm thinking, right? But then I look closer, I noticed the front part of the deer was a deer, the back half was a zebra. It was half deer, half zebra. So I'm like, oh shit, it's a deerbra. Like, that's what I'm thinking. It's a fucking deerbra. So I call the zoo, I'm like, yo, it's a fucking deer. He was like, what's that? I was like, half deer, half zebra. He was like, did you just make that up? I was like, I think so. He said, well, bring it down. So I get down there, he sees it. He's like, oh shit, it's half deer, half zebra. I said, that's what I was trying to tell you on the phone. It's a deerbra. He was like, okay, what do you want? Do you want money for it? I said, no, I don't have that type of time. I gotta get back to the car because my new son is in the car by himself. So I get back to the car. Turns out the baby that I thought was a baby wasn't a baby. It was a grown-ass man with Benjamin Button disease. Let me tell you how I figured this out. I figured this out. When I got to the car, the baby woke up. I was like, hey, I'm your new dad. I just adopted you. He was like, you ain't my dad, bitch. I'm 65. I said, God damn. He said, I got a disease. I was like, you got that Benjamin Button. He was like, where's my deerbra? I said, I knew that was a fucking deerbra. I knew it was. I just took it to the zoo. He was like, well, how the fuck am I supposed to get home? I said, you ride that motherfucker, man? Anyway, long story short, that's why I'm 5 minutes late for work, because it took a long ass time for me to get the fucking deerbra in the car. Understand something, people.